So you can use to study the reaction on the surface slab model. There are many types of calculation that you can use in WASP. You can use for the single point calculation, and you can use for the geometry optimization, and you can use for the frequency calculation, and you can use that for the your transition state and also the molecular dynamic. And in this session, we show you the example of input file in the single point calculation and how we like the geometry. When you want to learn what you have to think about these four files in car, post car, post car, and k point file. All these files store the different information data, and you can have in car that store your parameter that you have to set up, and the pod car that store the power potential data of your atom, and you can have post car to store the geometry of your system, and k point file that you can set up the k point mesh, and this four file have to be in the same directory. Otherwise, you cannot perform the WASP calculation. And you cannot change the name of the file. It has to be in a capital letter like this. There are a lot of important hacks you have to carefully set up in the in-car file, but we highlighted these three hacks that you set up for the single point calculation and for the optimize of your system. For the SW hack, it's a hack that defines the maximum number of the ionic step. For the single point calculation, you set this as a zero, and for the you want to relax the system, you can set more than a zero. And for the ion hack, determine that the atom are updated and move. And for the single point calculation, you can set as a minus one, that your atom will not move. And for you want to optimize your system, you can set as two for the gradient optimization. And the last tag is the L-sharp tag that you can use. You can turn on this tag. You can set add true to correct the shard information in the shard card file. It's very helpful if you want to analyze the shard density, and very helpful if you want to analyze the density of state. If you want to start with what and you're very new and you want to get started with your system and you don't know how to get the crystalline structure, you can go to this website, the materialproject.org. I will show you a little bit of how to access the website and get the data. And you can see the periodic one here. And if you want to access the data, you need to register before you get the see the periodic table like this. And you in that case, it will show you how to get the nickel crystalline structure. You can click that the element that you want, and then you click search. After that, you will see the page like this that shows you a lot of information of the histone structure of nickel. In this case, you can see it also show the 3D structure, and you can download the CIF file from this website, and you can click the CIF, and you click the compute. And finally, you will get the CIF file that you can visualize in the program like Vesta. Okay. There are free software for the visualization in what you can use Vesta to visualize the CIF file, or you can use Vesta to convert the CIF file from the material project website into the postcard, and you can use to convert back the postcard to the CIF. And we recommend this Vesta. You can access this program for free, and you can, if you want to visualize your atom movement, you can use the VMD for the molecular dynamic. And in case you want to analyze the density of state, this P4WASP program help a lot to analyze the density of state. And in atomic simulation environment is the Python library that provides you the many tools you can access all of this for free. So in this session, I will show you the example of the input file of the how we relax the CO molecule in the periodic box, and how we relax the nickel bound structure. And finally, we will show you some experiment to compute the absorption energy of the CO absorption on the nickel surface. Okay, we study the CO molecule postcard, you can see the pattern of the postcard. It like Dr. Pusana actually said in the morning section, and you can see the universal scaling and reactive parameter and the atom type, and then the number of atom and the Cartesian ordinate of the atom. So in the case of the CO periodic box, it have only two atoms, C carbon atom and one oxygen atom. And the K point, we set as a single K point, 1.1 is enough for the isolated molecule. So how you can generate the podcast file? If you, you need to generate the podcast file, every time you run the WAS, you can, you need to have the power potential library in your directory, and you, and in that case, we use the power PBE. You can create the podcast file by using a unique command like a cat command. And the command you can use, you just type CAT and point at the location of the power potential of the carbon atom and then the power potential of the atom. And you put this all together in the one single file, in the podcast file. So the generate of podcast is quite important because the order of the power potential in the podcast file needs to be exactly the same in the postcard file. And you can see if the postcard file carbon convert, and you need to get a carbon first. And after you generate the podcast file, you can check the order by using the grep command. You can type the grep and space, and then in that case, you get some keyword on the podcast file. And in this case, we get a title. And you can see the order of the podcast file. Before you leave the podcast file, you need to check the NMAC value of all atom, and you see the NMAC value of carbon and oxygen is 400. And you need to set it in the INCAR file. In the INCAR file, you can see we set the INCAR as equal to the NMAC value in the podcast file. That is enough, or you can set this more than 400. And we relax the system, and we set NSW tag at 100, and we relax system, and we use Iron at 2 for the conjugate algorithm. And after your calculation is done, you can see at the bottom of the outcome file, you can see this take as a series require accuracy and stop the structural energy minimization, and it means that your job is finished, and it provides you CPU time, so you can compare the computational cost from this line. And in case that you want the total energy, and you can easily get total energy by go to the OSCAR file, and you go to the last bottom line of the OSCAR file, you just see the E0, and you can grab the total energy. And after your calculation, you can see the concave file have been generated, and you can compare the geometry with the postcard. You can see it will be different from the postcard, and you get the new structure with minimum energy. In case of you want to relax bound, after you download that, I show you that from the material project website, you will get the crystal structure, and you. And in this case, you will see the FCC of the crystal have show one atom in the periodic box. And we use K point as high, and you see we use the 11 K point in the three direction, and index is you can get more accuracy because this box is very small. And you can see the NMAC value of the nickel is just 270. So we use NCAS at 400 is enough. In the case of metron, you use isomer S1 for the MacPherson pectin similar is proper for the metal. And in this case, you have to relax the brown structure. You need to set the SIF at 3 to relax the ion shape of the cell and volume of the cell. And finally, after your job is done, you can compare the reactive parameter from the concar and postcar, and you can see it totally different. And in case you want to study the reaction or absorption on the surface slab model, you need to enrich your supercell from the single cell to the supercell lighted, and you need to leave the vacuum space here because you don't want the interaction between the slab, and you need to enrush the AB direction because you don't want the south interaction of the atom or molecule that you want to study on the surface. But you don't need to relax all atoms in the slab because we study only in the top layer, and you need to keep the bottom layer remaining as bulk. And this is fine, it shows how you can relax and fix the atom of the single unit cell. Indicate you want to fix the atom, you need to add more light in the selective dynamic light after the number of atom here. And if you want to relax, you can put symbol TTT after the coordinate of atom. And if atom that you want to fix, you just put the FFF symbol after the coordinate of your atom. And for the K point, for the clean surface lab, you can you just use only one K point in the C direction here because it is in the response space is very small, and you just use one is enough. And it's quite exactly the same with the bulb, but you need to change the ISIF from 3 to 2 because you don't want to relax the cell shape and cell volume, and you relax only the ion. And finally, you have to create your system that you want to study, and you can create the podcast by adding C and carbon power, by adding the power potential of the C and oxygen atom in the podcast file. And for the K point, you just use the same K file at the clean surface as 991, and in car file, it's exactly the same with the clean surface. And for the post car file, you just need to add the C atom and oxygen atom here, and you can see we already add C and oxygen atom here, and add the position that you want to investigate. Finally, you will get the total energy, and you will get the total energy of your system. And you want to study, you can get the total energy of the CO isolate molecule, and you can get the total energy of the nickel clean surface. And finally, you can calculate the absorption energy. So my part is in here. So next, with Dr. Salawood part, he will talk about how to calculate the density of state.
If no question, I will start my sessions about the density of state. It's very important because the density of state give you about the electronic property. That is the main property that you want to know when you do simulation, right? So I just want to introduce you a bit about the density of state. What is the density of state? I have to say that a cell constant solution to the quantum equation result in many quantum orbital and the corresponding quantum energy for the set of K point. And we can get those results by grouping them according to their orbital. And those provide the distribution of electron state in the K space. And as shown here in this equation, dot is defined by the number of state at each energy interval. You can see here from E to delta E. That's our variable to be occupied in the N band. And a dot at specific energy level does mean that there are many states available for occupation. If we integrate dot up to the Fermi level, we get the number of electrons in the system. And quite often we ask for a dot for a specific projected way, that means a P dot projected on the specific atom, specific orbital, like the S, P, D orbital. We can calculate it by summing up the dots over orbital atom species that you want to get the, it depends on the what information you want to get from those calculation. And I'm gonna show you how to run those calculation. So basically they have two steps. The first step, do a cell constant or relax calculation to get the convergent charge density that you know how to get the chart car, you have to turn on L chart tag, right? So you get the chart car, and then the next step, you just do non-consistent calculation with the last K point. I have to say last K point because last K point is very important. You want to get accurate DOS result or nice result for DOS calculation. You must set at high. You must set the K matching, it's high matching. And in car file, you have to push, there are some very important tag in car file for running WAS, for running DOS calculation. The first one is isomere. We usually set the isomere equal to minus 5 for the DOS calculation for the bulk material. And for the last system, if your system is very big, you just set it equal to 0. And the next important tag is the iChart. So just set it to 11. That you ask the WAS software to read the chart car file from the previous calculation. And the next important tag is a grid point along the X, Y, Z, and you can get this number from the chart car file. So just fill it in your in-car input file. So for WAS, for DOS calculation, we did the single point calculation. So you just set EEPROM and NSW like it. So you understand the meaning of the single point calculation, which means all atom or all ion are fixed. The next important is L orbit. There are two options for L orbit. Just set it to 10 or 11, and then WAS will write the two output file, DOS car and PO car. If you want to get the decomposed orbital like this, S, P, S, P, X, P, Y, P, C, and D orbital in decomposed X, Y, C, we have to set the low bit equal to 11. So after you finish calculation, you get the output for the DOS. It is a DOS car file, and the format of DOS car file like this. Maybe Dr. Pusana Kiari talk about. Okay, just remind you again, the first column is the energy, it is the absolute energy, and the next two column is the DOS spin up, spin down, but it depends on your calculation, it's non-spin polarized or spin polarized calculation. And the next two column is the integrated DOS. And if you set the L orbit to 11, you get the decomposition atom. Then the order should be write it, PY, P, spin up, spin down, PZ spin up, spin down, write it, and so on. This is the pattern of the DOS car output file. Ask software to decompose orbital. And the next output is the broker file. File contain the SPD orbital, side projected wave function character of each band. If you set the L orbit equal to 11, you get the DOS composition along axis like the Y, Z, X, like it. This is the format of the broker file. And normally when we plot DOS result, we plot in the relative energy to the Fermi energy. We not plot absolute energy. And the Fermi energy is the energy of the highest occupied electronic state. And you can get the Fermi energy. Just open the outcar file. Or you can use the command line like the grep to find the Fermi energy in outcar file. So you know the Fermi energy. And next, the important one, you have to plot and analyze DOS result. And the DOS car contain result about the DOS information, right? Is it easy? It's not difficult to plot total dot from the dot from the dot car file because you just use the 2RT column. But for the P dot, it contains a lot of many columns. So I suggest you to use the software P4WAS. And P4WAS can open with the WAS LAT. I have to say that the another file that contains result about the DOS and band is the waslan.xml. Remember .xml file, and this file, you can open this file with the graphical interface P4WAT. Okay, this is the official website of the P4WAT. You can go there and download software and install it in your computer, and then you can enjoy plot DOS analysis dot with this software. In this workshop, I give you three examples, including nitrogen bound, silicon bound, and carbon dioxide molecule. Three examples for DOS calculation. You should set the in-car file, write it for nitrogen bound calculation, for DOS calculation of a nitrogen bound. The most important tag is here, highlight here, I chart and L orbit. And you have to see the number of git along XYZ file in the chart, car file. And you have to set the K point at high K point to get a nice DOS result. And the next, we're gonna plot DOS of nitrogen bound by using P4WAT. Just open the software. And can you help me to demonstrate how to use the software? Okay, just open the software. And then open the .xml file, nickel one. Okay, just double click and then click at the electronic tab. And then DOS path brand. So easy, you get the total density of state of the nickel bound. And you can see, but it actually depends on your setting. If you do the spin polarized calculation, you get the state spin up and spin down. Write it. Okay, if you have questions, you can just raise hand up and you can ask me, stop me talking, and you can ask me anytime you want to. Every time you have a question. Okay, the next one is how to get the data from the software. You can export the plot into an image. Just go like this, grab, export, and save it at the .eps file name. So you get the image look like this. And in the case you think it's not the beautiful graph, you can export it at the text file, and you can plot it with the whatever plotting software that you love, like Excel file, Origin. Just export it at the data, raw data. And I give you the format of the raw data .dat file right here. And the back line separate the spin up and spin down. And the first column is the X axis and Y column. Just the value, this density, spin up and spin down. And the dashed line here is also the relative energy to Fermi level already. Okay, what's next? So what information we get from the DOS result? For example, in the case of nitrogen bound, if we look close looser at the graph, we can see that spin up and spin down is not symmetry. It's not symmetry, which means the system is magnetized, right? You have the and if we look closer again at the Fermi level, we can see that at the Fermi level, the DOS at the Fermi level is not zero, which means nitrogen is the metal. Okay.
We want to determine the symmetry, and then we conclude is it a system is magnetized or not. We can visualize, and there are any tool that quantify. We can make conclusion that the system is magnetized.
Actually, you can look at the Oscar, right? But I think look at the graph is easy than look at the Oscar. But you can check in the Oscar. Another output file, you can check.
Oscar. Oh, so the magnetization, then some number different from zero.
Right.
Okay, thank you.
So the next example is the silicon belt. Okay, set in car, ride it at a high K point. And I pick up this case because I just want to show you that in the case of silicon belt, after you finish plotting dots, you get the graph look like this. And you can see there is the band gap here. That means this material is the semiconductor. Just want to demonstrate how information we can get from plotting dots result by using a P4-bus. And next for the carbon dioxide molecule. So now we have two more options. Here, E-min and E-max. And the next one is the NE dot was this tag. For the NE dot is the number of grid on which the dot is evaluated. The default is 301. So if you want to get the nine result of dot, I recommend it to use a high number, set a high number for this NE dot. And for the E min and E max is the length of energy that you are interested, the range in the XYZ that you are interested to plot the dots, right? You ask the software to look in the length of energy. Could you please open the .xml file for the carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide molecule, okay. Okay, I have to check what I have to discuss with you about this molecule. Okay, this is the T dots of the carbon dioxide, and you can see the spin up and spin down right here. And this is symmetry, right? Because it's closed shell molecule, right? What's happened? Is this the oxygen molecule? It should look like this or it should different? It should different, right? And you could see something different, but I don't have the example of the oxygen molecule, and maybe you back to your room and you can use the software and oh no, because the WASP software is not free software, right? So you cannot calculate the WASP if you don't have the software, don't have the license of the software, right? And okay, next gonna lead you, I'm gonna show you how to plot the P dot, projected dot. Okay, to plot this, just go to electronic and local dots. Electronic tab, please. Okay, and go to local dots, path band control. Okay, to get the pop-up window like this. And now we're gonna plot P dots of the carbon atom. So we have to select carbon atom. Just place mouse over carbon atom and then hit the space bar to select the carbon atom. Okay? Now another tab. I think we should see the carbon in the description line. Okay, it's atom selection. one. That means carbon atom. Actually, we should see carbon atom, not just number one like that. And the next step, could you please go to this tab, another tab, command tab there. Okay. So now there is the option here, spin up and spin down. And you can select whatever orbital you are interacting in this tab. Okay, now it check all box, it check all box, I check because it's a total dot, right? So just deselect all. Okay, so now if we are interested all P of the carbon atom, just click, okay, select P, and then just add new line, got the C, P dot of the P orbital of the carbon atom, like this red line. Okay, do again for the spin down. And we have to check the inverse Y axis. Okay, so now we get the P dot, PX, PY, PC of the C orbital of the carbon atom of the carbon dioxide molecule. So it's very easy. So there is option you can select the color of line, maybe somewhere I cannot see. Maybe just, okay, that tab, click that. Okay. So you can select whatever color you love.